Hey guys, in this lecture, we'll learn how to share captions in the posts, and make sure a post is in a good shape before it can be shared. In the last lecture, when we send each post to the database, we only save the photo URL. So each post on the database now has this URL only. We'll now also add a caption to this post when we save it to the database. Basically, we simply need to input the content of the caption text view directly to this setValue method. This text property is an optional, so we need to unwrap it. All right, let's run the app and see. We'll need to do more work to polish this task, but this is a great start. All right, this annoying placeholder text shouldn't be here. Simply delete it in the camera storyboard. All right, let's see. Okay, here it is. Looks good. You can do Command K to toggle the keyboard if you want. We'll take care of keyboard stuff shortly. Let's first choose a photo as before. Let's say we do have some caption in this post. For now, let's just make sure everything is nice. We'll worry about hairy stuff shortly. All right. Fantastic. This is our new post on the database. It's working fine. Let's add more detailed stuff on this feature. These are like things like we should clear the inputs after sharing, switch back to the home view, or things like that. All right. First, let's see how we clear the inputs after sharing. Intuitively, we need to make sure that the post was successfully saved to the database before we clear out the inputs, all right? First, we simply set the text content of the caption text view to a blank string to fakely clear it. To clear the photo, we can reset the image content of the UI image view. If we want to reset it to the placeholder photo, we can initialize a UI image object which displays this placeholder photo and assigns it to our photo. The named input specifies which photo file we want the UI image to be associated with. To display the placeholder photo, simply use its file name as we did in the storyboard. You can also get the file name from the assets folder. All right, good. We simply inject this file name into the initializer of the UI image view class. All right, let's see if we need something else. Okay. All right, let's run the app. All right, let's check it out. All right, first choose some photo, then write a caption, and share. All right, fantastic. We cleared out the input after the data was pushed to the database. Now, it would be nice to switch back to the home view after sharing. A straightforward way is from this camera view, first to access the tab bar controller that this home tab belongs to. Okay, the self keyword here refers to the camera view controller. Its tab bar controller property is thus the tab bar controller containing this camera view controller. This tab bar controller has a property which can be used to access the view controllers that it contains. This selected index property returns the index of the view controller that is currently displayed to users. All right. Our tab bar has 5 views indexed from 0 to 4, corresponding to the tab bar items from left to right. Note that this tab bar controller property is optional, because for an arbitrary UI view controller, it might or might not be contained in a tab bar controller. In this case, we know for sure that it is contained in a tab bar controller, so we don't need to check nil or so. All right, to display the home view, simply let this index be 0. Right. Okay, let's see. The indices are 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Let's try posting something. All right, this looks nice. All right, we have a photo. Now, put down some caption for this post. All right, and then share. All right, fantastic. This is great, isn't it? This is our new post. By the way, you can choose whichever you want to switch to modifying the selected index. Okay. Our posting feature is working great now, but it's a good idea to make it more robust. First, we can hide the keyboard after users are satisfied with the posts that we're ready to share them. We can simply reuse the touchesBegan method from the signup view controller. Okay, let's see. All right. This method is used to detect a touch on the view, then resign the first responder if there's a touch. Similar to before, we can also dismiss the keyboard right away after users hit the share button, if the keyboard doesn't cover the share button. But this doesn't matter in our app, and you can just delete and comment it out. All right. Okay, let's check it out. You can do Command-Shift-K to use the keyboard. Touch the view to hide it. If we push the share button when the keyboard shows up, then we can also dismiss it after sharing. All right, now we'll disable the share button for bad inputs. In particular, we allow the text view to be blank, meaning a caption is not required. However, users won't be allowed to share blank photos. The logic will be similar to what we did to sign in and sign up buttons. We'll disable the share button by default and enable it only when there's a photo in the UI image view. Now, our selected image variable comes in handy. We can use it to keep track if there's a photo in the UI image. So let's create a method to check on the UI image. We're going to call it handle post, but it's up to you. Now, the selected photo is not nil, only after the user did pick a photo. So we'll check if this instance variable is nil or not. We only enable the share button if this property is not nil, meaning the user did choose a photo. Okay, you can see this in the extension. The selected image is only non-nil if an image is picked from the photo library. All right. Only in this case, we enable the share button. We do this by setting its isEnabled property to true. Otherwise, we'll always disable this button. In this case, this isEnabled property should be set to false. Okay, to visually see the effect, we can set a specific background color of the button for each case. For the testing purpose, let's use a predefined color for now. In the other case, let's just use a very different color, like blue. Okay. All right, now we need to decide when should we call to do this business. A great place to do this is to call the function in the viewWillAppear method. So let's override viewWillAppear and call this handlePost method on it. All right. Here's the app. Okay, the share button is blue and disabled when there's no selected photo. Now, let's choose a photo and see. Note that when users did finish picking a photo, the selected photo will be set. This means it's not nil because it's holding the picked photo. Then the share button will be enabled. All right, fantastic. Note that this viewWillAppear method is repeatable. Thus, it can always be called whenever the view will appear. So when we did finish picking a photo, the viewWillAppear method will be called. Or if we switch to the camera view from another view, the viewWillAppear will be called to validate the post. All right. Okay, good. The colors look kind of bad now. We should have chosen blue for valid inputs. But anyway, let's mimic the sign in and sign up case. When the share button is enabled, let's set its background color to black. A black color is just an all zero RGB color with zero transparent. And when it's disabled, its background color should be set to a sort of lighter color. We can use the light gray predefined color of the UI colored class. All right, let's check this out. Okay, let's see. All right, great. The button is grayed out and disabled when there's no chosen photo. And when users pick a photo, the button will be enabled and turn black right before the view appears. All right, good. Good. The post was saved to the database and the view was switched. However, when we switch back to the camera view controller, something's wrong now. The post is sitting nicely here on the database, so there's nothing wrong with the sharing process. The view appeared, and the handle post method was called, but the share button is still active. This means there's something wrong with the selected image. After sharing, the selected image should be blank again. In particular, after we push the post to the database, as we did to the image view, we need to reset the selected image to some desired value. In this case, we reset it to nil to disable the share button. If not, it wouldn't still keep the picked photo, which means it'd be non-nil, and the button would be active. On the other hand, if we reset it after sharing the post, when the handle post is called, the stuff in the nil branch will be executed, which will disable and gray out the share button. All right. Let's share a valid post again. All right. Okay. Now switch back to the camera view. All right, fantastic. Our sharing feature is much more robust now. The only thing left we need to worry about is to clear out the posts when users change their minds. So to begin, let's create a remove or cancel button somewhere on the camera view. Let's say we use a bar button item named like remove and put it in the top bar of the storyboard UI home view controller. To code up its functionality, we need to create an IB action and connect this button to the camera view controller. Okay, control drag this new button to the camera view controller to create an IB action. Choose action connection and name it like remove touch up inside. All right, great. Let's now focus on the camera view controller. This remove button simply clears out every input, which is similar to what we do after sharing. So we can reuse that snippet in the send data to database method. So copy over these lines to the remove button. All right, this repetition looks bad, so let's implement a function for this task. Let's say we name it clean. Its body will consist of the commands for clearing out the inputs, and simply call this method if needed instead of typing out those commands. Okay, let's see. Oh yeah, we need the self keyword to access this instance method in a closure like this. All right, let's see if there is anything else we need to do. Okay. Actually, let's run the app to see if our new button is working fine. Okay, let's see. The remove button is here. The user experience isn't great though. Let's choose a photo, then write a caption. Now clear them out. Great, it's kind of working, but we need to enhance the user experience. First, let's create an IB outlet for this remove button to disable it for bad inputs. Let's call it remove button. All right, we drag it to a wrong position. Simply do it again. We name it remove button. Okay. Wrong connecting point again. Just do it again. Again, we name this IB action remove button to customize some properties of the button. Okay. Now it works. Let's say we only enable this button after users picked a photo. so we can enable it in this branch of the handle post method. That is, if the selected image is non-nil, we'll enable this button. All right? If there's no image there, there's nothing to remove. So we disable the button. Okay. Let's run the app and see. Okay. All right, go to the camera view. Great. The remove button is disabled. You can see that for this bar button item, when it's disabled, it'll be grayed out automatically. All right. And because we disabled this button, it's inactive and we can't tap on it. If we pick a photo so that the selected image variable isn't nil anymore, it becomes active and we can tap on it. However, after that, it remains active, which is kind of bad. The reason is, for now, we only test valid inputs when the view will load. So we need to test for bad inputs again after clearing the inputs. The view remains appeared, so the view will appear method didn't get executed. Okay, let's pick a photo. Put down a caption, then remove the input. All right, fantastic. Our sharing feature is very robust now. Here's a cool thing. Let's say users are in the middle of preparing a post. If they switch to another view, then switch back, the post is still there. It's because the handle post method in view will appear detects that the selected image is not nil. All right. See you next time.